So I'm Daniel Barreto. I'm lecturer in geotechnical engineering, which is a branch of civil engineering, and I work at Edinburgh Napier University. I do a lot of research from both an experimental and a numerical modeling perspective on how soils behave, coastal defenses, rainfall-induced landslides, which are becoming more frequent and catastrophic as a consequence of climate change, as well as thinking of innovative foundations so we can build the infrastructure and the accommodation we need in Scotland as, you know, on top of those bedbugs that we have widely available without releasing large amounts of carbon into the atmosphere. Climate change, from my perspective, is actually quite important because as a civil and geotechnical engineer, all my work is related to infrastructure. And we need to make sure that the infrastructure we build and maintain has to be resilient. And climate change is bringing a new set of circumstances that make that quite challenging. You might be quite familiar with intense and rapid, as well as more frequent flood events. And all our infrastructure is nowadays interconnected, so that can derive in other consequences as our infrastructure gets affected. Scotland, as a small country, but with great ambitions, is a world leader in wind and wave energy. And those are very much within the realm of civil and geotechnical engineers, because we have to once again make sure that wind turbines and tidal wave bases and so on have to be stable. But we also are privileged to have a lot of peat coverage in Scotland, and that is important because it's a carbon sink. It has a big ability to store carbon. But that brings other challenges because we have to build on those peat bogs and areas. Scotland has wide-ranging contributions in terms of construction. There is a big area of research on sustainable construction and good use of timber. I believe more than anything by leading by example. While climate agreements internationally are ambitious, Scotland tends to make them even more ambitious. Again, it's not of no surprise that taking advantage of our geographical position, we are leaders in wind energy. And that is one of the things that is leading us to become eventually a country with the zero emissions. As a researcher who does both experimental and numerical research, I think one of the big things that we have to deal with is that we are able to do a lot of modeling very quickly with the computational power that now we have at our disposal. But many times those models are difficult to calibrate because we do not have enough data. Ideally, I would like Scotland to start leading more from the front on geothermal energy. It has shown already that it can lead both in wind and wave energy, but we have an untapped potential of geothermal energy, and as such, it should get as much attention and investment as wind and wave energy have got in recent years, because that will definitely help to tackle climate change.